Hey guys, we are in the basement, and today, we're gonna do a John's Arcade tech video. And actually, this is gonna be a pinball tech video. That is right, guys, we're gonna work on the Ghostbusters pinball machine. Yeah, guys, we're gonna bling it out just a little bit in this video. And actually, before we start, check this out, guys. The Robotron is working! So if you guys saw in the last video, the Robotron was down and the Tempest was down. Now, I haven't had a chance yet to work on the Tempest, but I had some time tonight to work on the Robotron, and actually all it was the battery. That's right, guys. There's actually a little coin cell battery that's on the PCB that kind of saves the settings and the scores. And when that battery dies, the game kind of gets a little upset, okay? And so it was upset, saying I needed to reset everything back to the default settings, which I did, but then the game wouldn't boot. And it turned out that actually the coin cell battery holder was stretched out, okay? And I think the ROM data got corrupted because it wasn't able to save properly. So I pulled the game out, I opened it up, I looked at the little coin cell battery holder, and I just kind of like bent down the little tab that goes on top of the coin cell because it was like stretched out. I bent that down, replaced the battery, turned it on, and bam, here it is working again. So I'm actually very relieved because I thought I had a bad power supply. Was not the case. Anyway, what are we doing in this video? Well, we're gonna be revisiting the Ghostbusters pinball machine. And if you guys saw the last video on this topic, we did the unboxing. And by the way, I am loving this game a lot, okay? Now, Stern has all kinds of like accessories and stuff for the Ghostbusters, okay? And they've got the side inner art blades, which we're gonna install in another video. They have a topper, which we might actually talk about. I'm actually talking to Stern now about getting a topper. So who knows? It's not cheap though. And then also they have this right here, which is a shaker motor. And that's what we're gonna do in this video. We're gonna install the shaker motor. Now, this is the official Stern shaker motor. It is the shaker motor Stern spike system, okay? Because the Ghostbusters is using the latest hardware, which is the spike hardware system, and the previous generation was the SAM system, which uses a different shaker motor. Now, I got this one at California Extreme. I bought it direct from Marco, and it really wasn't that cheap. It's $150. Now, there are third-party sellers that have their kind of their own design of this that are about $100. But Stern released a bulletin saying that if you use those you damage the machine, it kind of voids the warranty. And I was at CAX and they had a deal. If you bought it there, you got free shipping. So I'm like, you know, for an extra $50, I might as well get the real one. I don't think there's much of a difference. I think some of the third-party ones are a little more powerful, but I think some of those initially had some problems that were blowing people's node boards. But anyway, I have the official Stern one right here. Now full disclosure, I actually tried to do this video last night, okay? And I just got this thing from Marco. I opened it up and everything, and I realized after I opened it that I was missing all of the hardware because this thing screws to the bottom of the cabinet. And so I had to go to the hardware. I actually had to stop recording and go to the hardware store and get the screws that we're gonna need to mount this thing in here. But basically what's going on here is that there is a motor with this kind of off-center piece of metal here. And it kind of works like the vibration feature on your cell phone, just at a larger scale. And this motor spins and this off-center thing just kind of shakes the whole cabinet. And so this is basically the whole unit here. And then this right here is gonna plug into the node board that's in the game already. Ready, and then this is a cover that kind of protects it so you don't kind of, you know, so that this thing can't rest up against something and just kind of chew up the insides of your cabinet. So anyway, there's not much to this with the spike system. It's pretty much plug and play. The game code is such already that it's looking for this thing, and so this really is literally plug and play. It's just four screws and then we plug it in, and it's supposed to come with the screws. Again, for whatever reason, mine was missing the mounting hardware, and instead of contacting Marco or even Stern, I just went to the hardware store and I got the proper screws. And actually the instructions, which I left in my car, reference what size screws they are. They're like 832 screws, like 5/8 and I think 1/2 inch for the cover. But anyway, I got the screws. We're gonna screw this in, and it should be pretty straightforward and really simple, especially compared to the previous games, because the little T-nuts that we're going to screw into and the holes are already mounted and drilled in the bottom of the cabinet. And on previous games, you actually had to drill holes and it would come with a template. So we shouldn't have to do this with the spike system and these newer machines. So anyway, let's just kind of get to work here. Again, this shouldn't take long at all. So the first thing we need to do is remove the glass. And actually, I'm going to turn the game off. And on these newer Sterns, the power switch is actually right here. Which has never been a thing with pinball machines, like, since the history of time. Because, you know, usually you turn the pinball machines off by right down here. But that's not the case with the new ones. Mostly, I think, because they have the power supply mounted back there. They have, like, a switching power supply. But anyway, let's remove the back glass. It's pretty simple. They did change the design of the lock bar. Very different than how the Williams open up. It's more like an arcade game control panel now, how it removes. But so right there, okay. So let's remove the glass, and we got to kind of be careful here because it's tempered glass. So if it does happen to break, it just kind of just shatters into a bunch of little diamonds. And so be very careful when removing the glass. I've knock on wood, I've never broken a playfield glass, but I have broken back glass on my Whirlwind a long time ago. I had the I was messing around in the back box on the board. I don't remember, maybe changing batteries or something. And I put the back glass on top of the game and it slid off the game and just shattered on my basement floor. It was horrible. So all right, so we had the back glass removed. We need to carefully lift the play field. Now I'm gonna tell you guys that the hardware Stern uses for the hinge and all that is really not great compared to the old Williams. It's a very, very crude kind of system here. So I'm actually gonna put it up here first. I wanna get all the balls out so they don't bounce around. And this game has 6 balls, okay? So we're gonna just kinda come in here and remove all the balls. And I'm just manually moving the coil to get them out. Just keep going until I get all 6. I got 5 right now, and they're rolling all over the basement. All right, stop. All right, let me get the last one. Okay, so all the balls are out. So I'm gonna carefully just lift the play field up, okay? And when I say carefully, I mean it, because this whole hinge system is, I think it's garbage compared to the old Williams. Because I actually, last night, I was trying to do this before I realized I was missing the hardware. And I kind of got the playfield cockeyed, and I couldn't get it down, okay? And you can see right now, it's cockeyed. So you got to be careful. And I actually kind of banged up my side rails. So just be very careful on these new Sterns, because this whole pivot thing is not great. It's really not. And so don't be a John and scratch up your side rails with the playfield when you try to move it down. So anyway, okay, let's kind of look inside here. Now the Pro, just one thing to point out. So the Pro, which is what I have, the Ghostbusters Pro, which is the lowest model, okay, the most basic one, does not come with a shaker motor out of the factory. I believe the LE and the Premium do, but the code is still in the software, and you can add the feature, which is what we're going to do in this video. So anyway, if you look down here, okay, right here, there's 4 holes right here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the other side are T-nuts. And this is where we're gonna screw the shaker motor down into, okay? And if I read the instructions correct, I bought the right screws, which are 8/32 by 5/8 of an inch, I think it was. And, or actually, yeah, 5/8. The hardware store didn't have 5/8, so I had to get 3/4 of an inch. I'm sure we're fine. So the thing is gonna mount. This right here is the bottom, okay? And this is the top, okay? And we gotta kinda make sure this wire is kinda pointing in the right direction, because it's gonna plug in on the other side. And so we'll just kinda put it in like so, okay? And then let me get my screws, and we're just gonna screw it down, and then we'll screw the cover on. I believe too that I was supposed to get some kind of a sticker that goes on top of the cover, okay? Because this is the cover right here, and it goes over this after we screw it down. And I didn't get any kind of cover, so I don't know what's going on. So here's the screws I picked up. And again, you should get this hardware when you buy it, but for some reason, mine was missing it. It's an 8/32 screw. It's supposed to be 5/8 of an inch. These are actually 3/4. And what I also did at the hardware store is I picked up some lock washers. I'm just kind of adding this. I don't believe it comes from the factory kit with a lock washer, but I'm gonna add a lock washer just to make sure this thing's really secure down there. And really, all I'm gonna do is basically, I'm going to get these screws in here like so, okay? And then I'm just going to screw it through the T-nut and just kind of get this thing mounted down there. And it's kind of tight in here, actually. Hopefully, this isn't too hard. Ugh. Yeah, it's super tight. And there's wires here. Maybe I should remove the coin. Actually, I'm going to. Let's remove the coin bucket here. I think it's going to make our life a lot easier. Give us some more room to work with. Yeah. All right, now that I have the coin bucket out, I can really get to this a lot easier here. So let me see if I can at least get these started by hand. Okay, there's the first one. So let me just kind of come in here and just get this one started and make sure the thread I got is compatible with the T-nut, and it should be. Yeah, it is. So I'm just gonna get this started, okay? And then let's try to get the other four in here. Boy, this is tight, man. I think I might need to go get another screwdriver that has a magnetic bit. Okay, guys, I grabbed a magnetic screwdriver here, and I'm gonna carefully come down with the screw. Now, I already put the washer kind of over the hole, and I'm just gonna see if I can line this all up, but it's super awkward and takes a steady hand to get this started, so. All right, so I have that one started there. So I'm gonna go ahead and just put the other two in, but really, we're just putting the screw in the washer in the hole and then threading it into the T-nuts that are already in this cabinet. So let's do this one here. I'm just gonna take the washer and put it over the hole, okay? If you guys can see that. So I've got the washer there already over the hole. And then I'm gonna use my magnetic screwdriver to basically thread the needle, hopefully. Let's see if I can do it. And this is the hardest part of this whole install, right? So just kind of come down here. Try not to be too shaky. All right, there we go. So I'm just getting them all started, and then I'll snug them all up at once. Okay. And let's get our last one here. And again, I have the lock washer I gotta kind of put over the hole. And this one's in a tough spot back here. Gonna put it over the hole and then use my magnetic tip screwdriver to just thread the needle, hopefully. This is kind of annoying. It's just tight. All right, let me get this last one in and we'll come back. Okay, we have all four screws nice and snug. So now we need to put the cover on, okay? And this is held on with two screws. Actually, I'm gonna do the wires first. So you can see here that there's little wire holders or wire ties on the cabinet. So there's one right there that we just kind of snugged up for the flipper button. And then these wires here go to another holder. So I'm gonna kind of just feed this through this wire holder over here. Okay, and then you'll notice here there is a Molex connector, and the kit that I got came with two different adapters, I guess. I believe this one's for the spike system, okay? We don't need this one. This is the one that we're gonna need to use right here, okay? And these Molex connectors are keyed. So this here goes male to female, okay? This is more or less an extension cable, okay? And I'm gonna kinda just come in here and just feed this. This might be a better angle on this side. So I'm gonna come in here and just kind of feed this into the little wire holders right here, okay? Just so we can kind of neaten it up, make sure it looks kind of original and factory, okay? And then this is gonna come up here, and then we're gonna plug it into what I believe is a node board right here, okay? So it's gonna plug into that node board, which is right here, okay? And it's gonna go on this far right connector. Make sure you guys can see that there. Okay, so I'm gonna take our wire, our connector here, and plug it into this one. And again, this is keyed, so you can't put it in wrong, okay? And then we're gonna take this here and just kind of snake it up into here just so we can kind of make it look legit and original. And then I'll feed the wires down in here. The wire is actually a lot longer than we need it to be, but I think this little wire holder will kind of capture the excess. Okay. So that's basically it. So how do we do? Let's take a look here. So we have the shaker motor screwed down with four screws. Our wire's coming out of it. We should probably have it go to the side because the cover is going to go on. And we definitely got to make sure that the wires clear our the rotation of that metal, okay? And then I fed it into the wire holder. And then we have our Mullex connector here, wire holder up through here. And then it plugs into the far right location on the node board, which is right there, okay? And again, it's keyed, so that's the only spot it can go. All right, so why don't we put on the cover, and then really, that's it, we're done. All right, let's put our cover on, and we're gonna make sure the wires kind of exit on the side, and they don't interfere with the rotational piece of the motor. And I'm gonna see if I can get these screws started here. All right, we need to put the cover on, and actually, I tried putting it on with the 8/32 screws that I got, and I cannot get this threaded through here. So I went through my junk bin here, and I grabbed a couple of screws. I think these are 6/32 maybe. I have no idea, but they work, and they should work. So let's see if I can screw this on really quick. And again, I'm missing the hardware. I have no idea what happened here, and I wasn't gonna lose sleep over it. It's just a few screws, but it's a little irritating. All right, so that works fine. I don't know. Does that not look original? John, the screws are not supposed to be black. All right, let's just snug this thing on here. All right. All right, it's on there good, I think. Okay. All right, so that's snugged up. So let me go ahead and just neaten the wires here, and we're ready to test this out. Okay. I probably should contact them and say I'm missing everything. All right, so we're installed. So that should be it. And the wire's coming out of the side. It's not interfering with this, the spinning of the motor. And everything looks relatively neat here. I'm just kind of neaten this up a little bit more. All right, does that look okay? Looks legit. Let's put our coin bucket back in. Make sure it doesn't interfere with everything here. Okay, that looks good. Okay, so let's carefully put the playfield down and test this out to see if it works. And I don't believe that we need to turn it on or anything in the options menu. I don't think we need to say that it's here. So let me carefully lower this. Lights. Okay. All right, let's put our balls back in. And let's turn the game on. Okay, so I believe we need to go, I wanna go in the test menu to see if we can test it, okay? And I believe it behaves as a coil. So let's take a look here. Wait for the thing to boot. All right, so I'm gonna go in the test menu. And let's go to select to continue. Let's go to diagnostics coil test, okay? So that's the trough. So you can see back there, it says which one do you want to test, okay? So let's go through plunger, left flipper, sling, right sling, shaker motor, okay? So it says here, return equals 1, power equals 5, okay? So how do we test it? Oh, there we go, I press the start button. So it works. And I think we can turn the power down. Let's see. Return equals 1, power equals 5. Let me press. I thought that you can turn the the shaker motor intensity down. Oh, it definitely works. You hear that, guys? It's pretty cool, right? I've never owned a pinball machine with a shaker motor, by the way. So I was kind of excited to get this one. Power equals 5. I thought that you can turn down the intensity. Maybe 5's max. I'm not sure. Maybe I should look in the manual. Actually, I'm gonna do that. Hang on a second. All right, guys, so there is a way to kind of tone down the shaker motor, and it's actually in the adjustments menu. So you go here, and it says standard adjustments, and SPI, I think, are just general pinball adjustments, but the one with the Ghostbusters, I think, are the features just for this game. And it says maximal use, okay? And what that means, though, doesn't mean scene complete extra ball. Shaker motor optional, okay? So it says maximal use, none, minimal, moderate, long use, or maximal. Now that doesn't turn down the intensity of the shake. It just turns down how often it shakes. I'm gonna keep it on maximal for now. And I did some quick research also on Google, and it looks like you cannot tone it down. If you wanna tone down the amount of shake, you actually have to play with the counterbalance weights, okay? Because the more centered those weights are, the less crazy it shakes. And I guess there's also a little like board you could put on there with a potentiometer. So for now, we're gonna just leave it at maximal use. So let's just get out of here and let's try it out. I guess I'll put the glass back on. So let me throw the playfield glass on and let's play a game with the shaker motor and see how it feels. Because again, I've never had a shaker motor. I'm excited to try this. All right, I just started a game. I actually decided to leave the glass off because it's much easier to film pinball. It looks way better with the glass off. You guys can see stuff a little clearer without the glass reflection. So, all right, let's see how it feels. Oh, I felt a little vibration. Nothing too significant right there. So let's hit Slimer. Oh yeah, that was a good, right there. As soon as you hit him, the whole thing shook. And it wasn't, that's not too bad. It's not super annoying. Okay, I like that. You know, I was a little worried that this thing was gonna shake so much that I'd actually kind of regret it. And so far, I'm not feeling that. I'm gonna cheat, by the way. I really wanna start multi-ball. That's my goal here. And I have to confess, guys, I haven't really figured this game out yet. I'm not even positive how to start multi-ball. So the Scary Brother targets are up. Oh my God! This game is brutal. Come on, let's have a good game. Let's get multi-ball at least. I'm kind of starting to think my pinball machine is leaning to the right. All right, so it says 9 ghost caught. Extra ball at 47.
Reinforcement on the ESP.
So right now it's doing this ESP thing where you have to use right flipper. You have to guess which one it is.
Good guess, but wrong.
I guess wrong. So it shows you two cards. You have a 50-50 chance of guessing the right one. All right, so that was a cool vibration there. So it says Light Tobin Spirit Guide. Oh, are we starting the multi-ball? No, we're not. Navigate turns, okay. And then storage facility. I think when it goes to storage facility, it's capturing ghosts. I need to sit down one night and read the rules. No, don't dream. Yes, I'm cheating. All right, vibration's good. So let's try to hit the captive ball. Super jackpot's lit.
You're right, no human being stack books like this.
Alright. I got the super jackpot, that's good.
Super jackpot!
We really haven't had a completely successful test of this equipment.
Left ramp builds, myself. Then shoot orbits to collect. Storage facility. Alright, let's see what's happening here. Oh my God, did you see that? I just drained. I have two balls in the playfield. I shouldn't.
Get the extra ball.
The extra ball split right here. Nope. All right, let's try to go up that ramp. So what's this? All right, I think we're starting, okay, we're starting the storage facility multi-ball. So the whole thing is shaking like crazy right now, guys. Now it says recapture all the escape ghosts. Not shaking yet. Shakes. Shake, shake, shake. I'm having a pretty okay game. Of course I'm cheating, right? So the shaker motor feels awesome. Ah! Ah! Yeah, I really think my game is leaning to the right because everything kind of goes this way too much. We just got a free game.
Shoot again!
Which is meaningless in a home setting. Alright, here we go.
I'm studying the effect of negative reinforcement on the ESP ability. Tell me what you think it is.
I'll tell you what the effect is! It's pissing me off!
Oh, I see how that works. You keep going. My score is like 100-something million. Because I cheated.
The Larry brothers need to be fried.
So good at it. We got the Scolari brothers. No, no! How we doing? All right, I got out.
That was great.
High score number two. So I've actually had a better game without cheating. So 141 million. So we really got to experience the shaker motor, and it wasn't too obnoxious, which I think is important to me because I was worried it was going to be like so obnoxious. But it just, it's like it's happening and you subliminally like feel it. It's good. It's really good actually. So, all right, let's put the glass back on. But that's it, man. That's how to install the shaker motor. I don't think it was that bad. Is it worth $150? Maybe. I don't know. So, let me put the glass on. You guys want to do a couple viewer mail and we'll get out of here. All right. All right, guys, there you have it. That is the shaker motor install and some gameplay. Obviously, at home, you have no idea how that shaker motor felt, but I think it felt pretty good. It's not, like, crazy intense. I'll say that. It's not, which I think is better, to be honest. I know that, like, Coin Taker sells one that's supposed to be, like, 15% more crazy, but I really didn't want that. I wanted it to be a little subtle, a little more tasteful, and for $150, though, that's the big question. Is it worth $150? $150. I have no idea. We'll see as time goes on, but what I felt there initially felt pretty good. So, all right, and by the way, we're gonna do more Ghostbuster mod videos. Like I said, the next video we're gonna do is probably the inner artwork. I actually can't wait to put that on. I think it's gonna really make the whole game pop. So, all right, let's do some viewer mail. I got a few here. And by the way, if you want to participate in the viewer mail segment, you need to email them to me at blkdog7@gmail.com. That's blackdog7@gmail.com. In the subject line, please put viewer mail. Otherwise, I will not find them. So blackdog7@gmail.com. Actually, there's a couple things I want to do here. So you guys have been sending me stuff, and I want to thank you guys. And we're going to thank a couple guys in this video here. But this guy here, Randy, sent me, and Amy from Alexandria, Indiana, sent me a really nice letter. And bottom line is he saw these at a truck stop that he works at, and he thought of me and wanted to send me some Pac-Man novelty glasses. And so thank you very much, Randy. I mean, you guys are just amazing to me. But we have to put these on. We have to wear these. Do you guys think I'll look good in these? we'll hang these on the wall. I gotta cut these. There's like a little zip strip thing on here. Let me see if I can find some side cutters. Here we go. So these are Pac-Man novelty game glasses, okay? And Randy saw these and thought of me. So we gotta put these on, guys. What do you think? Let's see. Is that a good look or what? What do you guys, can I pull this off, you think? Is this woman repellent?
What's up, how you doing?
Randy, these are hilarious. And then Randy also sent me a token here. I guess we can read some of his letter here. Hey, what's up, bro? I am the guy who emailed you about the arcade-themed sunglasses. I saw these at the truck stop I work at and picked them up for you. I thought as much as me and my girlfriend Amy watch John's arcade, maybe John would hang them up in the basement or something. I will definitely hang these on the wall. I've never before seen Pac-Man sunglasses, and the truck stop was sent only 3 pairs, so I had to buy you a pair. I also have taped a token to this letter, the last known token to the arcade I grew up in called Pac-Man Palace. It was once located inside the Mounds Mall in Anderson, Indiana, 84 to 93. How cool is that? So he sent me a token here. Let's take a look at it. And so this is, it says on one side here, golfing games, and another side it says no cash value. Very cool, dude. Thank you. I will hang this on the wall next to the Pac-Man glasses. And I'm looking here. It says for amusement only, non-refundable golfing games. Awesome. Let's go on here. And then he goes on to say, I was there the day it opened and was also there the day it closed. Isn't that sad? You know, these arcades just come and go. You know, they're in our lives for a few years. I mean, all the ones I went to are gone when I was a kid. On the last day, they were taking all the cabinets out on dollies. I was getting ready with my last token to play elevator action when the man holding the dolly said, go ahead, play your last token. I'll wait for you to play, then I will unplug it. That's a sad arcade story. And I looked over my shoulder to see a Tron cabinet being wheeled out. I looked back at the man and said, I didn't have the heart to spend it, and I walked away with my last token with real tears falling from my face. Dude, this is not the token you sent me, is it? Come on. All right, dude, this is actually kind of touching me. I walked away with my last token with real tears falling from my face. Pac-Man Palace is now just a memory, but I kept that token in my wallet for 23 years. Oh man, come on. I held on to the token for the memories, and today I want you to have it. For all the great memories you have brought back to everyone on your YouTube channels, all the restoration of so many legendary cabinets, which I know is a lot of work. It's bringing back all those great memories of when we were all much younger, and that's what you do so well. Everyone loves John's Arcade. Famous forever and always a friend, Randy French and Amy Embry, Alexandria, Indiana. Dude, this is too much, man. Honestly, you had this in your wallet. You know, I didn't read this before the show. I didn't. And I'm actually touched by this. You had this token in your wallet for 23 years, and you want me to have it now. And you know what? I'm putting this in my wallet now. I'm serious. I am, Randy. This is gonna stay in my wallet. because it brought you good luck, and hopefully it gives me good luck here. And I think this is an important memory you shared with me, and I need to find a spot in my wallet here so I can't lose it. But dude, thank you so much, man. Honestly, that touched me. I was not expecting that. I wasn't. So Randy and Amy, thank you very much for the token and the sunglasses. You guys are truly amazing, and thanks for watching the show. And I promise to keep that token in my wallet. I'm not kidding. I'm keeping that in my wallet. I should probably like tape it to a card or laminate it or something so it can't fall out. But dude, thank you. Thank you so much. Wow. That caught me by surprise, I'm not gonna lie. I didn't really know the true deep meaning of that prior to this, to reading this. You had that in your wallet for 23 years, and now it's mine. Wow, dude, thank you. I'm not really good with whatever. Randy, thank you. I guarantee you, if you ever meet me, it'll be in my wallet, I promise you. So, thank you. So, moving on, the next one here is from William, and he says, John, thanks for all the vids and for keeping arcade games alive. Here is a token of my appreciation, a velvet Q-bert. I do velvet paintings and thought you would appreciate a bit of kitsch. Plus, Q-bert hasn't gotten much attention lately. Keep up the excellent work, William. And here is this painting he made for me. How awesome is this? Yes, I have the best fans in the world, guys. Seriously, you guys are just amazing. I love this. I absolutely adore this. This is going on the wall ASAP. I will put it over here somewhere. I will find a good spot, but this is staying in the basement, absolutely. So this is a velvet painting, which he's right, it's total kitsch. Let's look at it up close. He signed his initials here, WBV. P.S. You should play some more Firefight and Truck Driver Sims. That was funny stuff. He's talking about on my John Sucks at Video Games channel. I streamed a truck driving simulator and also a Forest Ranger Firefighter Watch. The game is called Firewatch. So William, thank you so much for this, too. You guys are amazing. Honestly, thank you so much. I have the best viewers and fans. Honestly, I do. So guys, thank you so much. You know, I'm gonna stop here. And we'll save these other viewer mails for another episode. But I really wanna thank William for this painting. And my God, I cannot believe Randy and Amy sent me these glasses and a token he had in his pocket for 23 years. So, all right, guys, we're just going to end it here. Thank you very much, everyone. If you want to send viewer mail, send them to blkdog7@gmail.com. And I hope you guys enjoyed the Shaker Motor video. Again, we'll be doing more Ghostbusters stuff. And, of course, check out my podcast, Arcade Outsiders, at arcadeoutsiders.com, Video Game Outsiders at videogameoutsiders.com, and You Suck Show at yousuckshow.com. And we're going to be doing more videos more frequently over the next week here. I actually took some time off, and I'm trying to get caught up. And I know that you guys probably weren't expecting this video, but I kind of wanted to put that Shaker Motor in. I was very excited to try that out. So anyway, we'll be doing the BroFest in California Extreme. We're going to be doing some Hong Kong videos. We're going to be doing a Xenophobe video, and of course, the last part of Quantum. All of that's coming up here. I have so much to do. So anyway, that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you very soon. Later, and bye!